If you really cared about women, you would care about their choices and their decisions and respect them.
Ireland has a near-total ban on abortion. In Northern Ireland, the 1967 Abortion Act for the UK does not apply. This means that every year, thousands of women from Ireland and Northern Ireland are forced to either travel abroad to England, Scotland, or Europe for an abortion, or face an unwanted or problematic pregnancy.
Emma is in her early 20s. She devotes all of her spare time to campaigning for abortion rights as part of the Alliance for Choice.
I organise the Alliance for Choice stall on a Saturday. It's usually we would do about 2 to 4 in Belfast City Centre, just giving out information about abortion rights. It's really important because so many people in Northern Ireland don't know what the law is, and loads of people think that you can get abortions in cases of rape and incest and in severe abnormalities, but you can't. If I grew up where you grew up, I would just have to go to my doctors and they would then be able to send me to get those exact same pills. Whereas here, it's like you have to go to your doctor and you have to tell them what's happening. You need to like organise your flights, organise your accommodation. You need to book time off work. It's not like you can get your NHS abortion still. You have to go and pay private healthcare for it.
If a woman orders pills online, what could happen?
If you've ordered the pills online, you've had an abortion, you can face up to life imprisonment. If one abortion's illegal, it doesn't stop abortions, it stops safe abortions, and that there causes more damage.
Every year, thousands of women travel from both the Republic of Ireland and Northern Ireland for abortions. The cost of doing this can run into hundreds and thousands of pounds. But for women who can't afford to leave these countries, their options are limited. They can either see an unwanted or problematic pregnancy to term, or they can illegally order abortion pills from the internet.
Abortion medication is very safe. It's on the World Health List of safe medications. It's safer than Viagra. It's safer than aspirin. It's the exact same medication that you would get if you went to any hospital in the UK, including hospitals in Northern Ireland, and you had a partial miscarriage. You will be offered this medication in order to complete the miscarriage. Women are able to access from two providers, or the two main providers are Women on Web and Women Help Women. Recently there has been a clampdown, and I think that's very worrying because it appears they are targeting activists as well as individuals who have purchased the pill. But that leaves those individuals concerned in a really worrying place, you know, not knowing. You know, maybe if you've ordered the pills recently and you're thinking, are the police going to turn up at my door? You know, am I going to be targeted next? And that's just going to add to the stigma that women are already feeling about the situation.
Over the last 8 months, the Northern Irish and Irish authorities have been seizing an increasing number of abortion pills in the post and raiding the homes and workplaces of women suspected of ordering them. Helen has recently had her workspace raided by the PSNI. Their search warrant says that they were looking for what they call instruments which could be used to cause an abortion. What do you think they were looking for?
I haven't a notion. I mean, what were they looking for? Coat hangers? Knitting needles? You know, I really don't know what they thought they were going to find, or whether they thought that there was some sort of backstreet abortion going on here. I thought it was quite a heavy inventory of documents they were looking for: bank statements, laptops, computers, mobile phones, anything that had internet capacity. So I think that they were probably trying to, or are actively trying to, build a case so that they can take this forward. When I was around 16, I got pregnant. And when I think back on it now, I didn't really want to have sex with a guy, but, you know, it just happened. So when I think back, it was probably closer to a rape than a sexual encounter. And I became pregnant, and I was very lucky. I went to my older sisters and they were able to help me out. And I had to go over to England for an abortion, and it cost a lot of money at the time, and there's a lot of secrecy around it. And I just thought that this isn't right, you know. And as time went on, there was other people I knew. And also now I have a daughter myself who's 21. But whenever she was 16, 17, they were talking about things like that. So, you know, I've always been active in campaigning and taking part in any campaigns that would be happening, because it's just so wrong that, you know, and I know women in their 70s who campaigned 40 years ago and we're still campaigning today, and I really don't want my daughter and her children to have to be campaigning again. We are criminalising women who are in poverty because they order an abortion pill. We don't criminalise women who go to England, who can afford to have it. We don't criminalise people who give you the money to go to England, but we criminalise women who order the pill. I know that public opinion is with us. I know Amnesty did a big report, and most people agreed that abortion should be free, safe and legal for women who have fetal abnormalities, and also in the cases of rape. So, I mean, if we could get to that place, you know, we're moving to somewhere that's more acceptable.
At the Mary Stopes Clinic in the centre of Belfast, a limited number of abortions under very strict restrictions do take place. Naomi is a Mary Stopes escort. In her free time, she accompanies women using the services here. That means taking them to or from their particular mode of transport or back to their hotel if they've travelled a long way across Ireland.
What's the atmosphere like outside? What do you guys come up against?
Well, usually there are two escorts. One wears a body cam, and that is to capture anything kind of untoward. It's to record and film anything that might happen. We have had people assaulted. We have had escorts assaulted in the past. The kind of thing that you will encounter is they will try and engage with the women. But it is not engagement about the right to choose or about abortion or anything like it. It is, again, about stigmatising the women, about shaming them.
Naomi takes us to the Peace Wall in Belfast. It was erected during the Troubles, but now it bears a bright pink pro-choice mural. Naomi says this reflects the appetite for change in the city.
I was motivated by having to travel for my own abortion to England. I was faced with a crisis pregnancy at the age of 40. I was forced to travel to England in order to access what should be reproductive health care and should be free and readily available to women.
A woman's bodily autonomy is a fundamental right, and if you don't have that, you know, then rights are pretty meaningless.
Earlier this year, a public forum in Ireland called the Citizens' Assembly voted to recommend the introduction of unrestricted access to abortion in the country. They voted 64-36% in favour of having no restrictions on abortion in early pregnancy.
They voted for the various restrictions that they may want to have in place, and overwhelmingly choice was what they voted for. They felt that women should have no restrictions as to reasons up until a certain gestational limit, but it was an overwhelming showing that when people are presented with facts and testimony, they choose choice. It would be very foolish of the government to ignore yet another cry for repeal of the Eighth Amendment. Women are still travelling, 12 women a day, 12 women tomorrow. You know, that doesn't change. There'll still be, you know, 3,000-4,000 women who have travelled this year. So we'd have to keep always remember that and always bring that to the politicians. All of these people deserve to make decisions about their own body, or at least at the very least deserve to vote on what happens to their own body, because most people of reproductive age have never had a say in this.
While there may be a referendum on abortion in Ireland soon, the Northern Irish situation is rather different, with Theresa May's government looking to join forces with the anti-abortion DUP. Women in Northern Ireland still face a long journey before they have the full freedom of choice, which should rightly be theirs.